May I answer, sir?
Please proceed, Secretary.
I have not been involved directly with the peace process. I have never participated in any of the meetings of the government panel and the NDF. I look at my work in DSWD as part of the efforts of the Duterte administration to bring services to the people that they need. In terms of peace, I think we all understand that the president from the beginning had said we cannot have a country always on war. We have had war for the past 40 years. We don't want to see it for another 40 years. So peace is a condition for development. And development is a requirement for peace. The two are interrelated. Okay? So we are the Social Welfare and Development Department. The president tasked me to provide the services to the people that are of immediate needs during disaster, during crisis, to sectors who are marginalized and vulnerable. I have done that as the immediate response of the government, but I will really look forward to a time that we have really reduced poverty because people have land, people have jobs, that we don't need to give educational assistance because people have access to free education, that we don't need to give burial assistance or medical assistance because hospitals are free. So what we're doing now are really stopgap measures under conditions of widespread poverty as well as climate changes. And have been doing that as my own contribution to the president's efforts of achieving peace and development. What actually has happened is one, I think the peace process under the Duterte administration has so far been the most advanced relative to previous administration, I think, except for President Ramos' time where several agreements were signed. Here, I think they have had several meetings already. And I'm happy to note that both panels have been working towards social and economic reforms, which we support wholeheartedly, especially land reform. Many of the Pantawid Pamilya beneficiaries are farmers themselves or who do not have land. I hope I have answered your question, Senator.
Well, Madam Secretary, I was hoping that you would let me off the hook and limit me to one question. But please forgive me for saying that your response, no, I don't mean this in a negative way, no, has generated more questions than answers. Because poverty alleviation, livelihood, no, the socio-economic reforms that are at the core of any serious peace negotiations begins with the termination of the armed conflict. Hindi tayo pwedeng maghanap buhay habang nagbabarilan, no? And which leads me to my second question. From where I sit, and for better or for worse, we chair the Committee on Peace, Unification, and Reconciliation. No, I have not conducted a single hearing because I was allowing, I was giving all the instrumentalities of government a chance to focus on the more important and urgent task at hand. I also happen, for better or for worse, to be chairman of the Committee on National Defense and Security. Okay. So I will go back to my question. While you are talking, I'm talking about government, not the peace negotiations, there have been attacks on police stations. No. The armed conflict has continued. And when the question was asked publicly why this is ongoing, the response was, we have no control. Okay? We have no control over those who are perpetrating this. Now, if there is no control, the next logical question is, why have you not condemned these attacks? Now, of course, you look at it from a different perspective. So if you have no control and you do not condemn, the next question is, why are we talking? Okay. I hope I'm communicating this properly. So I'm not burdening you with a categorical response to this question. But we cannot talk and fight at the same time.
But Mr. Senator.
Yes.
I am the Secretary of the Department of Social Welfare and Development. I am not an NDF representative. I think that should be made clear. I was nominated, recommended by the National Democratic Front, but I am not NDF. So I cannot answer your questions, which you think I am part of the decision making. I am not. I was a professor at the University of the Philippines when I was appointed by the president. So I am not in the capacity to answer why are they still doing that. I think it is up to the National Democratic Front panel and the Philippine panel to answer your questions. I'm sorry I cannot answer it in my personal capacity or even in my official capacity as secretary.
Madam Secretary, I perfectly understand that. That's why I premised my questions on your views, your insights. No, because the peace process is not the end, it's only the beginning. Kanina po, nung nagsasalita kayo, sabi ko, lagot, now I have agitated Secretary Judy Taguiwalo.
Thank you. I hope I won't be agitated today.
So I have asked those questions now in the proper context. Now, let's bring it up to speed. No? Okay. Could you please update this the commission, this committee, on the status and the condition of the Marawi evacuees? Because let me again explain. No? Terrorism, no? It may seem, Madam Secretary, that I'm focusing on variables that are not within your control. You are correct, no? You head a department that is responsible for social welfare and development. I'm not imposing that burden on you that you have control over the NDF. I'm not even implying that you are a member of the NDF, okay? I'm not also implying that you are insulated from this. Okay. So the status and the condition of the Marawi evacuees, because it is my view that terrorism did not begin and will not end in Marawi. The armed conflict did not begin and will not end in Mindanao. In fact, the prognosis is it will become bad. It will become worse before it becomes better. And that is precisely what we are trying to avert. And nobody said that the peace process will be easy, no? So that we can reasonably begin in a starting point and then proceed to your mandate, which is social and economic development, poverty alleviation. Okay. So I go back to my question. Ano po ba ang status ngayon ng efforts natin sa Marawi evacuees?
Dalawang bagay lang, Senator. Ano? Last night, may meeting kami with the President and the representatives from Lanao del Sur. And the President was very clear about the roots of the problems in Mindanao. Terrorism is a offshoot of, sabi niya, the issue of land and the historical experience of Mindanao with colonialism, as far back as Spanish colonialism and American. So I think the President is very clear about the roots of the armed conflict in the country. And I'm happy to know that because I'm also a professor of history. Sa Marawi ho, mula May 23 ho, nag-start yung siege with the attack of the Maute. May 26 ho, nag-umpisa na tayo ng mga evacuation centers natin. Until now, we have 75 evacuation centers, no? Open ito out of the 135. Ang karamihan ho ay nasa Pantaurabat. No? So meron ho tayo, we have a regular update ng Marawi. We can give you copies of it. But the other day, we already deactivated our response cluster to turn over to the new task force Bangon Marawi, headed by Secretary Lorenzana, the overall efforts at reconstruction and rehabilitation. But we have provided financial assistance for IDPs of, hindi ko na mabasa ito.
Madam Secretary.
370 million pesos. So I just want to tell you, we have been there since day 3, no? Kasi day 3 nagdatingan ang mga evacuation. We are still there, and I would like to again commend our workers in Field Office 10, in Field Office 12, and then the ARMMDSWD, the LGUs, and the CSOs and volunteers who have worked closely with government so that we can provide assistance to the IDPs. But the problem is far from being solved. They are still evacuees. They cannot go back to Marawi soon, but we are preparing for the transition, Mr. Senator.
Thank you, Madam Secretary. Last two questions. First is, you mentioned that this is a forward-looking peace initiative on the part of the present dispensation, and the last one you mentioned was under President Ramos. No? I'm sure you have in your arsenal of historical data the initiatives of the late Haydee Orat, the six paths to peace, which I think will be valuable as we look back from where we have been and how to move forward. No? So I just wanted to put that on record. Now, my last question is, with the things you mentioned, that we are, things you are doing in Marawi, is this indicative of institutionalizing this effort so that, you know, Madam Secretary, napansin ba ninyo na itong nangyari sa Marawi, if you look back to recent history, I was still wearing the uniform then, no? When Jolo town was burned, and then Ipil, Zamboanga, and then Zamboanga City. Ang nagbago lang, yung petsa at saka yung mga personalidad. But almost the same situation. That's why it underscores the need for institutionalizing our efforts so that the places that are affected, whether it's natural or man-made calamities or terrorism, no, certain programs, long-term programs, are set in motion. Whoever is the SWD Secretary or whoever is President of the Philippines. That's my last question.
I think while war has been a regular event in our country historically, iba ho itong maute at abusayap, no? Kasi walang rules of engagement, hindi sila nagpa-follow ng international humanitarian law, which the other armed groups, including the NPA, the MNLF, the MILF, as far as I know, recognize. Kaya nga talagang malaki ang galit ni President sa terrorism as represented by Mauten Abusayap. Kasi wala eh. Walang pagpipigil, walang pagdistinguish between the armed combatants, between the combatants and the civilians. So yun ang siguro ang linawin natin. Ang sa iba hong mga armed groups, I think ang sabi ni President, may ideology sila. They have rules of engagement, rules of war. Pero siyempre, ganoon yung one. There are still ups and downs sa mga peace processes, sa mga peace talks. So I hope that is clear because we deal with the terrorist groups like the Maute, Abusayap in a different manner from those groups that have actually a program of government, have actually rules of engagement. So, hindi ko alam ang detalye. Huwag nyo na akong tanungin kasi wala akong arsenal kaugnay ng peace talks. May arsenal ako tungkol sa kasaysayan ng kababaihan at ng social welfare sa Pilipinas.
Well, Madam Secretary, Mr. Chairman, with your permission, forgive my limited vocabulary. No? Maybe it's my previous calling. No? But my point really is, terrorism, is driven by an idea. Okay? Whether there are rules of engagement or not, the fact is, life, liberty, and property have been put in jeopardy. Now, how do you fight an idea for terrorism, for a caliphate, for an Islamic State? With a better idea. You deliver on food, clothing, shelter, education, and health services to begin with. No? So that's what I was diving at. That's why I was asking for your important views on the peace process as a starting point that will pursue the trajectory of relief, rehabilitation, reconstruction, and then eventually poverty alleviation, and then delivery of basic services. But having said that, Madam Secretary, I would like to thank you for your patience. I think whatever happens this morning, we should continue this conversation. Thank you, Madam Secretary.